Alack, I'm afraid they have awakened, and 'tis not done. It is the attempt and not the deed that confounds us. I have laid the daggers ready. He could not have missed them. Had he not resembled my father as he slept, I would have done it.
I have done the deed. Didst thou not hear a noise?
I heard the owl's screams and the cricket's cry. Did not you speak?
When?
Now.
As I descended?
Aye.
Methought I heard a voice cry, "Murder! Macbeth does murder sleep. Therefore Carrero shall sleep no more. Macbeth shall sleep no more."
Who was it that thus cried? Why, worthy thane, you do unbend your noble strength to think so brain sickly of things. Go get some water and wash this filthy witness off your hand. Why did you bring this dagger here? It must lie there. Go carry it and smear the sleeping grooms with blood.
I'll go no more. I am afraid to think what I have done. Look on, I dare not.
Infirm of purpose! Give me the dagger! The sleeping and the dead are but as pictures. 'Tis the eye of childhood who fears the painted devil. If he doth bleed, I'll gild their faces withal. For it must seem their guilt.
Whence is that knocking? How is it that every noise I hear appeals me? What hands are here? They pluck out mine eyes. Will all of great Neptune's ocean wash this blood clean from my hands? No. This my hand will rather the multitudinous seas incardinine, making the green one red.
My hands are of your color, but I shame to wear a heart so white. I hear knocking the south entry. Retire we to our chambers. A little water will clear us of these deeds. Hark! More knocking! Get on your nightgowns. Be not lost so poorly in your thoughts.
To know my deed, to have best not know myself. Wake, Duncan, with thy knocking. I would if I could.
The king is dead.
In the name of your dark magic, I have come to seek my future.
Spake and I'll answer.
Tell me what is to come. What am I to fear?
Come.
Last time I was here, when I looked there,
I found that no man born of woman could harm me.
Yet I shall make double sure his death should guarantee my safety.
Secret desolate shade. There, cry our sad bosoms empty.
Let us rather take fast or mortal swords and, like good men, defend our country. Scotland suffers under Macbeth. He's much too harsh. Let us end Macbeth's terrible reign.
Indeed, Scotland cries in pain.
We must take responsibility.
Hey, you seem true, good Macduff. Together, we shall battle the evil Macbeth.
Lord! Lord Macduff!
A messenger.
Let not your ears despise my tongue forever, or shall possess them with the heaviest sound yet ever heard.
I guess at it.
Your castle surprised, your wives and babes savagely slaughtered. To relate the matter upon, where, on a query of these murdered dears, to add the death of you.
Merciful heaven, what man? Silence will only overburden the heart. My children.
Wives, children, servants, all that could be found.
I then said it. My wife too?
I have said, sir.
To be the medicine of our great revenge, cured his deadly grief. My wife and children shall avenge.
Hang out banners on the outward walls. Wherefore was that cry?
It was the cry of a woman, my lord.
We'll find out.
I have almost forgotten the taste of fears.
The queen, my lord. She's dead.
She should have died hereafter. There would have been time for such a word.
Tomorrow, tomorrow, and tomorrow creeps in despair. Pity pace from day to day, until the last syllable of recorded time, and all our yesterdays have lighted fools the way to dusty death. Out, brief candle. Life is but a walking shadow. A poor player that struts and frets his hour upon this stage and is then heard no more. It is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. Prepare the troops for battle! Bring me my armor!
Yes, my lord!
They have tied me to a stake. I cannot fly, but bear-like I must fight the course. What is he that was not born of a woman? Such a one I am to fear, or none. What is thy name? Thou be afraid to hear it.
No. Though thou callest thyself a higher name than any is in heaven.
My name is Macbeth.
The devil himself cannot pronounce a title more hateful to my ear.
No, nor more fearful.
You lie, hold tight. With my sword I shall prove the lie you speak.
Of woman, but swords I laugh at, weapons laugh to scorn, brandished by man that was of woman born.
Why should I play the Roman fool and die on my own sword? Whiles I see the lives, the gashes do better upon them.
Turn, hellhound, turn! Of all men else, I have avoided thee, but get thee back. My soul is too much charged with blood of thine already.
I have no words. My voice is in my sword, thou bloodier villain. Then terms can give thee out.
Worthless effort to fight me. I bear a sham life, which must not yield to one of woman's born.
Let the angel whom thou still hast served tell thee. Macduff was from his mother's womb untimely ripped.
Accursed be the tongue that tells me so, for it has cowed my better part of man.
Then yield thee, coward, and live to be the show and gaze of the time. We'll have thee as our rarer monster are, painted upon a pole and under writ. Here may you see the tyrant.
I will not yield to kiss the ground before young Malcolm's feet and to be baited with a rabble's curse. Though Burnham would come to Dunsinane and thou oppose being of no woman's born, yet I will try the last. Before me I throw my warlike shield. Lay on, Macduff. And damn be him that first cries, "Hold, enough!"
Thank you. I will not fight thee anymore.